Fiancé. Hook Macapula fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Divisions. There is no three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. In case a cut is caused by an accidental headbutt, we go to the scorecards if the four rounds have been completed and you cannot be saved by the bell in any round, including the 12th and final round. Brian.
All right, Harold. Time now to get a little taste of their differing personalities. Macapula, very religious, and he likes to come out singing.
He sings a well-known song in South Africa, which translates to "I am not alone," and it's a well-known song. According to Macapula, everyone when he in South Africa when he enters the ring sings along.
Where's the music?
Very confident guy, and he really believes in himself and the Lord. So he's here to prove it tonight.
He was born in East London, South Africa, resides in Johannesburg. He has fought 26 of his 31 professional fights in his homeland. And you can see he's getting ready. He's waiting for the music.
Many fighters are religious, and many of them use religion, whether, you know, maybe unwittingly, as a way to feel that they're fighting for something bigger than themselves. So in the event of a gut check fight, they have a little more to go to, a reservoir of strength maybe that they feel they wouldn't have otherwise.
He says when he sings, that gives him true power. He really feels the power.
While he's... That's the one.
Jorge Arce has not fought that many times in the United States. Most of his fights have been on pay-per-view. Most Americans haven't seen Hulk fight either, Max.
Yeah, he's been in there with some good opposition as a pro. Hasn't beaten good opposition recently, though he is on a winning streak. He says when he sings this song, by the way, it takes him to another planet. And I think he'll find on that planet later tonight, there's going to be a guy breathing down his neck throwing punches.
Why don't you ever think about singing on your way into the ring here?
No, but you know, if I ever seen a guy singing coming into the ring, you know, I would believe that he's not serious about the fight, but Macapula is definitely serious about this fight. Very religious, as you can see, he's taking it very seriously. And this is an important song for him.
And a thoroughly decent guy. He said, he told us that he prays for his opponent before the fight. Not just, you know, he wants his opponent to do well. Unfortunately, it's only two guys in the fight. Or perhaps with the referee and the Lord. It might be four guys in there. I don't know, according to Hawk. But he actually prays that Arce does well, not just comes out safely.
Lennox, let me ask you this, because usually you came out second as the champ. Did it have any effect on you if a fighter had a long ring entrance? It took a while for him to get in the ring before you could actually get going?
No, not really. In fact, it's a ploy. Longer you take to stay in the ring, longer you take to get into the ring, the guy has to wait for you, your opponent has to wait for you, and by that time he's getting cold. And that's what you want him to do, get cold. Get real comfortable in the ring and wait for you.
It's interesting. Usually the guy that enters first is made to wait. But Hawk, whether he realizes it or not, makes his opponent wait even if he enters first. What do you know about entering first, Lennox? You were always entering second. How many times in your career did you come in first?
Well, a couple times. And when I seen the other guy coming in the ring, that just really got me mad and riled me up. I really got excited. I really wanted to knock him out.
Crowd here at Dodge Arena getting a bit antsy. Nearly 7,000
and they have come to see Jorge Arce. They'll get to see him in a minute, but first now, a closer look with Max.
With my fight with Holyfield in New York, I came in.
You know a guy's a headliner when he remembers the one time he came in first.
And Holyfield was actually singing coming into the ring. The second fight he wasn't singing though.
Closer look, Max. Closer look. Hawk Makapulu is a 96 Olympian who missed the bronze medal by one fight, didn't medal because he lost in the round right before that. He's a preacher. He's also a marriage counselor. And he gives unsolicited marriage advice, as we can tell you after the fighter meetings. And by boxing standards, an old man. 33 years old, nowadays isn't even that old for many divisions, but for a 115-pounder, it's ancient.
Arce, born in Los Mochis, Mexico, the Mexican cowboy. He wanted to come in on a horse, but arena officials wouldn't allow it, so he fires up a Harley here, and a lollipop to boot.
Sounds like a roaring lion coming into the arena.
Hawk, you go ahead and sing, I'm gonna cruise in on the back of a Harley.
And the reason people love this guy, crowd-pleasing, is the bike ride ends at the ring. Once he's in the ring, never up on the bicycle. Or the motorcycle, as it were.
Seven-year-old Jorge Arce, not a very long amateur career. As is the case for most Mexican fighters, he turned pro early.
And not just the showman and the guy, or he doesn't really build himself as Hamed did in many ways. Nassim Hamed is a guy you love to hate. He's a guy who's easy to root for, very charming personality, not just gregarious, but actually charming. Nice guy.
Although he may have been taking notes from Ahmed back in the day, cruising in here on a Harley.
Who else could come in on a motorcycle with a black cowboy hat and he's the good guy? Fighting a preacher, still the good guy.
Arce salutes the crowd. The crowd appreciates it. A closer look now with Max.
Nicknamed Travieso, which literally translates to the mischievous one, but he translates the spirit of the word as the little rascal. One of the reasons he was so popular on that Mexican reality TV show, Big Brother VIP. As I said, a reality TV star. There he is, Jorge Arce. See, I said that already. Brand little rascal, reality TV star. And he's learning English from his girlfriend, who speaks English very well and teaches him well, and just the willingness to want to learn English for a Spanish-speaking fighter who's already popular in Mexico shows how savvy he is in terms of his legitimate attempt to become a crossover star.
Both fighters have made their way into the ring, and now for the official introductions, we send it into Lupe Contreras.
From Dodge Arena, Hidalgo, Texas, we welcome you to an evening of boxing after dark being brought to you by Bob Arum, Top Rank Incorporated, in association with Bronco Sports Productions and HBO Sports. This is the main event of the evening. A 12-round WBC Super Flyweight Eliminator. Supervising for the World Boxing Council, Bismarck Morales. Our judges are Ray Hawkins, Oren Schellenberger, and Robert Tapper. Our referee, Vic Draculich. And now, damas y caballeros, just steps away from the border of Mexico. The moment has come to find out who is El Mas Macho? Introducing the blue corner. He steps into the ring wearing red, white, and green. And weighing in at 114.5 pounds. His professional record, 28 victories, along with 3 losses, and 18 of his victories coming by way of knockout. The former junior flyweight champion of the world and currently ranked number 3 by the WBC. Fighting out of East London, Republic of South Africa, Masibulele, the Hulk Makhebula. Across the ring in the red corner, he steps in wearing blue, trim, and green, and weighing in at 114.75 pounds. His professional record, 44 victories, with only 3 losses, 1 draw, and 34 of his victories coming by way of knockout. The former mini flyweight, former flyweight champion, and currently ranked number 1 in the world by the WBC. El Orgullo de los Mochis, Sinaloa, Mexico. Jorge, el travieso Arce.
All right, gentlemen, this is a WBC Super Flyweight Elimination Bout. You receive your instructions in the dressing room. Again, I want to caution you. Any punches below this point, going to be called low. Golpes de bajo, de este punto, ser llamado bajo. With that said, I want you to obey my commands, protect yourselves at all times. Obedezco mis comandos y protegerse a su mismo siempre. Touch them up now, good luck to both of you. Tócalo.
We got a guy who loves to press the action against a guy who loves to counter. On paper, shapes up nicely. Let's see how it shapes up in the ring.
Both these fighters are in the midst of some nice winning streaks. Arce hasn't lost since 1999, 24 in a row. Makhebula has won his last 8. Incidentally, Arce has won his last 7 by knockout. Match, he told you what his game plan was going to be. Why don't you share it with us in the early going?
Hawk, did you mean?
Arce.
Arce, jump on the guy and hit it and keep throwing punches. No, his prediction was he's going to move around for a couple rounds and then end it in the fourth. He didn't put it to rhyme as Muhammad Ali would have, but he didn't come far away either. Had we allowed him to keep talking, he might have.
Both fighters boxing the conventional style. It is definitely a pro Arce crowd here in Hidalgo, Texas.
Champ, does it surprise you how aggressively Makhebula came out?
Just wanted to really test him out and see, you know, part of his game plan was just to go in there and just throw a couple punches, put him against ropes, and then step back and see what he came back with, but he didn't come back with anything.
He meaning Arce didn't come
Arce.
Back.
Arce, though, establishing early that he is going to jab towards the body. And there you see it again. Said he wants to break down Makhebula's body.
Hawk also mentioned that he wanted to attack the body. That Arce doesn't like it there, as though anyone does.
Makhebula trying to press the action up against the ropes. And there you've seen the fourth straight jab to the body from Arce. Lennox, you like that theory? some good power shots from Arce there.
Good hooks to the body from Arce.
You like the jab into the body, Lennox?
Yeah, jab sets everything up. One jab, he definitely wants to test out the jab to the body because Arce's belly looks a bit bloated. I think he ate some spaghetti before the fight that didn't go down.
Arce's body looks okay to me. What are you noticing? What bloating are you noticing, Les?
Just right at the top, right here in the midsection. Mm-hmm.
I wish I bloated like that.
When we go to the corner of Jorge Arce, where they speak Spanish, Ray Torres will do the interpreting.
Don't follow him. Keep him at a distance, half a distance. Don't follow him. He's waiting for you. He thinks you're going to jump on him, so take it easy. How you feeling? He's too slow for me.
The mouthpiece. Play to the end, walking away.
Stompy box power punches in the early round. Off Makapula. Landing a third there. 8 of 26. Arce just 3 of 14. So Arce promised to be the busier fighter. Feeling his way through the first round. Arce has been on some undercards of some pretty big pay-per-view fights. There you see the scorecard of Harold Letterman giving the first round to Makapula.
Makapula is very calm in there, very deliberate with his punches, taking his time.
He performed well on the undercard of Mayweather Judah back in April of 06 this year, and the knockout of Rosendo Alvarez.
You know, Alvarez, though, was a shot fighter. He was done. And there was some give in him. And Makapula, though he hasn't been in with top opposition recently, is not a shot fighter. He's a guy who still thinks he can win and has been on a winning streak. And I don't see any give in him. Not yet, anyway.
On the undercard of Morales Pacquiao in 05. And there you see Arce getting busy. Committing to that hook to the body.
Makapula came back with two, now three very well-placed body shots.
Very good body shots.
The marquee fight for Arce was the fight with Hussein on the undercard of that Morales Pacquiao matchup. 10-round TKO. His nose was cut early in the fight. There was blood everywhere. This guy says he likes to bleed.
Actually, it winds him up when he tastes his own blood and sees his own blood.
And that was his signature fight. The first Hussein fight where he scored that 10th round knockout.
Makapula settling in nicely. He had two left hooks and came back with a straight right that shot through the guard of Arce. Big right hand right down the pike from Makapula.
And this is why perhaps Arce felt he should move around the first couple of rounds. You heard in the corner, his corner tell him he's expecting you to jump on him. He's very natural counterpunching, Hawk. Very schooled counterpunching.
Plus, he's coming from a gym with a lot of good boxers in South Africa. So as far as sparring partners, he has no problem getting sparring partners. His gym's full of them.
50 plus pro fighters in that gym. Meanwhile, excellent exchange in the corner and along the ridge.
Arce. Doubling and tripling up on the hook. Makapula countering when he can, but Arce forcing the action against the ropes. Both fighters letting their hands go a little bit more in round two. This
this Tuesday night, catch the premiere of Wait Till Next Year, The Saga of the Chicago Cubs, a documentary about one of baseball's most popular franchises and how they and their fans have endured a World Series winning dry spell dating back to 1908. Each Wednesday night, it's the Emmy Award winning Inside the NFL. Join hosts Bob Costas, Chris Collinsworth, Dan Marino, and Chris Carter for a unique and in-depth look at the National Football League.
He's very slow, so can't. But be careful, make him miss. And then you can land your punches when you make him miss.
Guys, would you say that that round was good, excellent, or fantastic? I think I'm leaning towards excellent for the second round. That was excellent.
Very good round.
Any better than that, it's fantastic.
Those fighters turned it up in the second round.
Usually that's the way it's been going tonight. All the fighters have been turning up in the second round.
Stop. Referee, good Draculich. Warning Arce about a low blow. Arce committing to that hook and tapped him there on the belt line.
To see Arce really wants to mix it up in there. He wants to get in there and throw some punches.
But Makapula so far doing a good job of firing off some heavy artillery when Arce tries to stand in front of Trey.
A really good matchup so far. Evenly matched, competitive fight. Fast paced.
Nice long right hand from Jorge Arce. Arce wants to force the action to the ropes and then let his hands go. Two good hooks that catch Makapula right in the midsection, and Makapula now digs deep as he tries to find the leverage of right hook and connects on a straight right that got Jorge Arce's attention. Arce now firing. Makapula temporarily stunned.
Arce has him hurt. Makapula's fought back valiantly till this point, but he appears hurt.
Nice counter for Makapula as he tries to steady himself. Another strong right hand. Guys, we're in for a fight.
Oh, we're in the middle of a great one, of an excellent one.
Big right hand from Arce, and he lands flush with another left hook. Makapula off balance.
Here's the moment of the fight where it crossed the threshold from excellent to fantastic. Makapula has to make a stand.
Makapula looks pretty shaky on his feet right now.
He has the willingness to, clearly.
Doing a good job, though, is off Makapula.
Makapula
regaining his bearings.
He needs to get off the ropes, though, because he's at a disadvantage when he's on the ropes.
I don't know, Lennox. It looks like his legs need the ropes for support.
Definitely, his legs are affected.
Arce catches Makapula with a left. Can Makapula hold on through 10 more seconds? Clearly hurt, not firing back. Big round for the Mexican Cowboy here in the third.
Don't get overconfident now. He takes a lot of punches. Yeah, it was a good round. Don't move your hands now.
He's gonna come out smoking now. With the hands up, use the ring. Don't get your ass on the ropes. Please, Baba.
You're gonna see that punch that hurt the Hawk. Good right hand. Boom. That was it. And this is him pouring it on at the end of the round. Sentient victory.
Or
Jorge Arce, he's been known to throw 100 punches in a round. 41 of 97, according to CompuBox there. In the third, Makapula 17 of 56.
This was his prediction round, fourth round knockout, and it looks like he's in position to make that come true.
Let's take a look at Harold Letterman's scorecard. Harold, how do you have it through three?
Okay, friend, the scorecards don't show much because that third round was a huge round. 29-28, Hawk Makapula. I thought he won the first two rounds. You know, Jorge Arce just didn't seem to get off. Hawk Makapula counted beautifully. In the third round, there was just no contest. Arce hurt him with a right hand early, staggered him, he's got him hurt right now. It's definitely, the momentum is all with Jorge Arce.
Oh, he just got hurt there with the left hook.
That's right, he caught him when it took that scraping left foot.
Oh,
and Makapula gets trouble.
He's going.
And Arce trying to finish the deal early in the fourth round. And Makapula goes down.
I don't think he's going to make it. It is over.
Vic Draculich waves it off 1 minute into the fourth round. The Mexican Cowboy, Jorge Arce, in his first fight at 115 pounds, brings the power in the fourth round, picking up his 25th straight victory and eighth in a row by knockout.
Hawk Makapula deserves a ton of credit for making this such an entertaining fight. He was willing to trade. He was trying to do all the right things. Old for the division, facing a comer, a young guy who's very aggressive.
Arce said he's going to do it in the fourth round. He did it in the fourth round in splendid style.
Lennox, let's take a look at see how this knockout developed here in the fourth.
It basically all started with that left hook. That left hook caught him right on the chin, and he wasn't able to recover from that. And then Arce just took advantage from him right from there and took him apart.
I don't think he'd ever recovered from round three, where I think it was also really a left hook that initially got Makapula into bad trouble in the third round.
And let me tell you, in the third round when he was going back to the corner, he was shaky on his feet. He didn't walk back in a straight line. It almost looked like he was a bit lubricated.
Inebriated?
That too.
Came out a bit inebriated.
Jorge Arce, he said it is important to him to be a crowd pleaser. And you can tell by the reaction after the knockout, he feels like he did his job tonight. Let's send it in now to Lupe Contreras for the official particulars.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Vic Draculich stops the bout with an official time of 1 minute even of the fourth round. Your winner by way of technical knockout, Jorge El Travieso Arce.
Jorge Arce moves to 45-3-1. He's just 27 years old, but he turned pro at 16, so he has a deep professional record. More importantly, has not lost since 1999, when he lost to three-time former champ Michael Carbajal in a fight he was winning until Carbajal caught him with a right hand in the 11th. Final punch stat numbers now for this matchup between Arce and Makapula. Both guys were feeling each other out early in the on, but Arce turned up the heat, landing.